the world to places near and far. It's time to cruise above the clouds, no matter who you are. Together you and I will fly the world from Milan to Japan.
Gentlemen, this is Captain Rimming speaking. Please make welcome the one and only air hostess to the stars and beyond, Miss Pam Ann.
We've got plenty of it. Thank you, sweetheart. That was a scary gay terrorist. Well, hello, Abu Dhabi. Hello, Qatar. Hello, Bahrain. Hello, Saudi Arabia. Look at you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome aboard Pam Ann Flight 269, non-stop to Dubai. Oh, how excited. Well, not that excited. OK, that was excited, but that's too much excited. Hello, economy! I see dead people. Well, tonight, joining us in my VIP Beyond First Class cabin, taking us hostage over a kebab, is my own in-flight terrorist, a man who just loves hanging out at airports for fun. Egyptian-born comedian Akmal Saleh is here. Also on board is a man who looks great in a burqa, poking around in my galley, cooking up a storm. It's international radio and telly icon, star of Simon Townsend's Wonder World, Jono Coleman. You. Look, stand up, look at the camera. Fashion. We're going to Dubai. Love you. What's your name?
Suzanne.
Tonight it's hello, hello, hello. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to fasten your grenades to your waists. And pay close... and pay close attention to your in-flight video and see how my One World Alliance deals with a terrorist situation. Fuck off. Go on. Fuck off. Fuck off. Trace, Donna. Yeah? I think we've got a hostage situation. Yeah? Holding up the plane. Do you know what to do, Trace? Ah, I don't know what to do either. Hang on a sec, I'll just find out his name. Hang on. What's your name? Jack. Hi, Jack. Hi, Jack. Did you get there, Trace? Hi, Jack. Hi, Jack. Hi, Jack. You got a bomb? You got a bomb. Trace, I think he's got a bomb. Gotta go, Trace. On you get. Behind. Oh. Lord Virgin Blue. Now, I know a few of you are a little nervous flying today. You're a little bit paranoid, and a lot of you are looking at me for reassurance, and I can see you looking at me thinking, I wonder if Pam knows how to disarm a terrorist at 41,000 feet with a full face of MAC makeup whilst fighting a fire over the Pyrenees without spilling a drop. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you now. This is quite random, but seeing you've dressed up and you look amazing, I've got all my passengers on board. What's your name, darling?
Chris.
Chris, come here just for a second. This is quite random. Okay, now what I'm going to show you now how to disarm a terrorist at 41,000 feet. So what the terrorist is going to do, okay, he's going to come up behind you and he's going to grab you from behind, okay? And then I'm going to be bending over at that time. I would have bent over to pick up a fork. The terrorist has come up behind you. There's going to be a struggle, okay? There's going to be quite a big struggle. Darling, what is that? Get carried away. Gay terrorist. Okay, then what you do is you startle the terrorist with your blue eyeshadow. Startle. Oh, fantastic. You're amazing. Startle the terrorist with the eyeshadow. Grab the Clinique toner from the duty-free trolley. Throw the Clinique toner in the face of the terrorist. Therefore, blinding and exfoliating the skin at the same time. Thank you, darling. You like that? I love flying with Arabs. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will be playing a game later on in the flight, and I need to select two wannabe terrorists that can go into our training camp. I'm thinking you, sir. You're quite a big, strong man. What's your name?
Paul.
Paul, come here, Paul. OK, round of applause for Paul. So we'll take Paul, and I think we might go with a female terrorist. I think Suzanne from earlier on, seeing she's dressed in that lovely outfit. Okay. It's Paul. So Paul and Susan, we're going to take you away. We're going to see you a little later on for our game called How to Disarm a Terrorist. Off you go through the curtain. Can you smell something? You smell something burning? Yeah. I think we have a celebrity in my galley kitchen. Shall I find out who it is? Yeah. Oh my God, look! It's John O'Donnell!
Hello.
Mwah. Lovely to have you in my galley
Always
kitchen.
Always great to be in your galley.
I nearly didn't see you. I'm like, Jono, look how thin you are. You've lost so much weight.
It's done with the high pressure on the on board
and
the plane.
On the plane, yes. Isn't it? And you've got lovely first class sleeper suit on there.
The great thing is, even if you don't fly first class, you can go in and steal the pyjamas.
Oh, that's great, until you sneak up through the curtain.
Well, look, all those years going backwards and forwards from the UK to Australia, it was you had to find things to do. Everyone else was sleeping or shagging in the first class toilets. So what I would do is sneak into the galley. Hello, attention. Sneak into the galley. And make myself a snack.
What have you made here?
Well, I've got... Because we're going to Dubai.
We've got a
bit of a kebab. Well, it looks like a kebab or something that fell out of the first class
toilet.
Is this
out of the 24-hour deli?
Yes. Looks like I've been to the vet. The thing
looks like something you'd get on Jetstar.
Oh, yeah. And have to pay for it.
And have to pay for it. They don't have a menu.
I tell you what,
they have a price
The thing is, the weirdest thing, true story, I was actually travelling on a flight once to Dubai or back from somewhere, and I was paranoid about some of the looks of some of the customers, some of my fellow passengers. I went into the bathroom after somebody came out, and I was so paranoid. I looked down on the floor. There was this black cylinder rolling around on the floor. And I stayed in there 5 minutes thinking, do I flush it down? Do I try and defuse it? Whatever. Anyway, cut a long story short, I came out and I grabbed a hostess and I said, excuse me, I'm so worried. I don't want to cause a stir or anything. I found this black cylinder. And she said, that's what the toilet roll goes on. That's what you call paranoia.
Paranoid.
35,000 feet.
Paranoid.
And I thought, instead of just getting paranoid in the toilets on my own, I would come to the galley and make something to eat, because what can you do on a plane? You can join the Mole High Club.
And you have joined
the Mole High Club.
I'm not quite sure
who it was with.
He logged his nine inches.
I think it was Ray Fiennes. I'm not sure.
I love how Jono's partially gay sometimes.
Yes. Yeah. Only when I'm on your show.
Only when you're on my show.
I know my wife's not watching because we haven't got this channel.
Oh, really? Yeah. Well, I think you'll be getting that. I'll be calling your wife. I'll be sending it to her.
No, but the interesting thing is, actually, the truth be known, we did, myself and Margot did join the Mile High Club on a Cathay Pacific.
Your wife?
Club. Well, then she wasn't.
Oh, OK. So what happened? How did you fit in? How did you fit in there back then?
Well, she was tiny. She's stick thin.
So you're stick thin. And so what are you doing now, Jono? What are you...
I'm shagging here.
Oh, no. Shagging here?
What am I doing now?
You came back to Australia. You're in the UK.
Yeah.
And you've come back to Australia.
Oh, God, I didn't know I was back in Australia. I thought we were on the way to Dubai.
We are on the way to Dubai, but apparently you live back in Australia.
I do, yeah. I came back. I thought...
I forgot I was going to Dubai. Sorry about that.
It's the jet lag. I think that the thing is, once you've come to Australia, once you've experienced the wonder that is your audience, look at these people. How could I spend 16 years in London be missing Australians and New Zealanders and all the gays and the Mardi Gras and stuff? So it was just time to come home. And also, I think I got out at just the right time. Well, you know, life was great, but, you know...
The credit crunch has hit.
Yes.
Prices have gone up.
Yeah.
Jetstar have taken their wings off and are chucking them like javelins.
Exactly. The best thing about the credit crunch is that we can't afford to eat out as much, so I think we'll be...
We can't afford to eat. And I mean, the one person that does... The one airline that doesn't have a problem is Emirates.
Yeah.
They've got so much fuel, they wash their planes with fuel.
Exactly. And also Air India. If you want to lose weight, Air India is good because basically they let people in economy go up to first class and beg for a meal. It's actually quite good.
Delhi Belly's good for as well.
Exactly.
I like a Madras for my economy passengers on any flight. Mm. I love seeing them run to the toilet.
Bit of Delhi Belly.
What happened to Woodrow?
Well, he's actually in
here. Oh, my God.
Look, see, he used to get one of those a lot, actually, with
Simon. What's this,
Jono? Oh, my God, it's a bit of mid-air turbulence.
Oh, my God, we've got some turbulence.
Oh, my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, like fasten your seatbelts.
It's like an old episode of Star Trek.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your first officer, Captain Rimming, speaking. We're currently flying over the state of Qatar, the only country named after a thick build-up of phlegm. Hard sell for the tourist industry, one would imagine. Anyway, enjoy your flight. Sorry about that. But better out than in, eh?
Everybody, but I think I know who it is. Yes, it's my very own in-flight terrorist, Akmal Saleh!
Hello.
Akmal.
Hello, don't be scared.
Oh, my God.
No, I'm not, this is not dynamite, this is Frankfurt. And if you don't do what I say, I'm going to force-feed people Frankfurt.
Ah.
They're going to die, but much slower.
Ah. Max, you are...
Yes, this is... We're in first class, Max. I had to... you get your pianist.
Yes.
And your very own terrorist.
You can only do that job once, can't you?
I know, once, but, you know... There'd probably be a lot of loser terrorists who have to come back home alive.
How is it...
What happened? I lived. I fucked up.
So you live as a terrorist?
Yes, that's my full-time job, yes.
And I love it. So do you love travelling?
Yes, I love travelling. It's fantastic. I like to go to the airports and just... speak Arabic very loudly.
So do you do the PAs? Like,
okay. Yeah, yeah, especially in Sydney Airport, it freaks the hell out of people. Muhammad Ali Khalid Ala Huna!
I think it's also fun on the train as well. Just
yes,
it's popping on with a moss clock and going hala mala.
Hey, in some suburbs in Sydney, that's quite acceptable.
It is quite acceptable.
Have you been to Lakemba?
Been to Brighton Les Sands.
Oh. Have you been? Well, yeah. Anyway, it doesn't matter.
I've been to Paradise, but I've never been to me. But 72.
You've never been to me either.
72 virgins, is that true?
72 virgins, yes. I would prefer sluts.
Really?
Because you know, there's the terrorists in England in jails are now being deprogrammed.
How do you deprogram someone like that? With
well, they've been doing
help.
It. Don't worry, that's not. This is just fun. Later spanking. No, because they're deprogramming them but they're going too far. They're turning them into English backpackers.
Oh.
They're going from Islamic fundamentalists to drunken louts going, get your tits out for the lads. and they're going to live in Bondi. And when they die, they're gonna have 72 slappers.
And what about gay terrorists?
Gay terrorists that's a whole different breed.
Because I know there's a few people on my plane today that would make one of become like, terrorists. Gay terrorists. How are they?
Hi everyone. We're gonna die in the name of Allah, okay? Don't be scared. 1, 2, 3.
So do you get fisted when you go through customs and immigration? Do they always pick on you?
Did you say I get fisted?
Well, you know, a full cavity.
Oh yeah, I got fisted in New Zealand of all places.
Really? What happened?
Well, you know these little cute dogs.
Yeah.
And they have got these little beagles, right? And this dog came and started sniffing around me. And
I hate the beagles.
Oh, but they're cute. Cute little dogs. And I just patted the dog and it was so cute. And then I felt this big hand on my shoulder and he says, sir, we're gonna have to conduct a strip search. That's how they talk.
Really?
And I said, come on, man, don't put me through that indignity. And he says, well, this is true, right? He goes, well, our dogs are really accurate and this one was really keen on you. And the next thing I know, I'm completely naked, bending over.
That's hot.
Well, no, it was hot. If you've been behind me, it would have been hot. But I had a big Maori guy with tattoos.
Really?
Yeah. And I'm bending over, right? I'm like, I had to grab my ankles and I had to, I don't want to be too graphic, but I'll have to spread them. I had to spread them, right? And in the middle of this, I'm really getting upset by this stage and I swear to God, I'm not making this up. One of the security guards behind me says to me, or the customs officer says to me, so, have you had a good day? I'm like, yeah, it's great, thanks. Welcome to New Zealand. So that was, it's funny, isn't it? I was dressed like this, so maybe that's...
That's probably why. Hang on, who's this?
Who's this?
Hello?
Pam there.
Oh, Danny.
Seems to be a small problem. It looks like I'm booked into economy. I don't think I can sit in economy because, like, this jacket would need a seat of its own. So I was just wondering if you could do me a little upgrade or something because I could get you onto Australia's Got Talent or The X Factor, come and meet Simon Cowell, I teach how to sing. Who bailed you out when we were kids and you got caught shoplifting at Kmart?
Shush.
Think about it. Pam, come on. Who taught you the dance moves to This Is It?
You did.
Come on, do it with me. This is it.
Ooh. This time I know it's the real thing.
Oh, Pam, please give me an upgrade.
Maybe a coat. I think the jacket, the coat's already up there in first class.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's got a seat of its own.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, it's been an absolute joy to be hijacked by
you.
Oh, you're wonderful.
Anytime you need a hijacker, I'd be offended if you went to anyone else.
I think Max quite enjoyed it as well.
Hello, Max.
In a quiet sort of way.
I had to do that because he's seen things that you shouldn't see.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the fabulous Akmal Saleh! Please remain seated. See you after the in-flight announcement when we'll be playing our game, How to Disarm a Terrorist.
Yeah! Yeah.
Did I scare you? We're currently flying over Egypt. Fuck me, we just missed a fucking huge triangular building. Didn't see the fucking bastard. We just hit a camel as well, so please, for those of you sitting on the left, sorry about the hump in the wing.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to play our in-flight game, How to Disarm a Terrorist. Passengers.
We're worried, we're worried.
Okay, and our two contestants from earlier on have been given a crash course at the local terrorist camp. Okay?
Now, there are a lot of people here dressed as terrorists. That would be a great opportunity for a real terrorist to come here. Yes, I'm here for the Pam Man show.
Yeah.
Not real bullets, no. I don't know, maybe.
It's Aladdin doll. He's in a pan.
That's a shitty
bullet. Is he scaring you?
That's right.
Sorry, darling.
Which one's Danny Minogue? Has she got the upgrade
the
yet?
The middle one.
Take me to Lebanon nice or I'll rob my lamp.
Get back in your terrorist position. Now, the aim of the game is to collect the device without our passengers knowing, OK? So we're going to put a device here.
Ooh.
Yeah. And a device here.
Oh.
OK? Oh. Right behind you, Jono.
Is that what it is?
There's a curtain behind each of you.
Yes.
And the terrorists are going to come through the slit.
Ooh. You can do that in this time slot.
Yeah. I think I've paid for something.
Okay, without any further ado, let's play our game, How to Disarm a Terrorist. Yeah. Yay! So you have to look around and stop if they move.
Does it matter if I can see him there?
That's cheating.
Suzanne.
My one's scared to come out.
Oh.
It's the first one to get the device.
That's the best
looking. I can just keep looking at him though, right?
Right.
Hey!
Unbelievable.
What an amazing game.
I thought it was Cat Stevens.
Suzanne, come here. You're our winner. You take away this lovely terrorist guide to flying a plane. It comes in two CDs. The first one's how to fly a plane. The second one's how to land a plane. But I don't think you'll need that.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, aren't they wonderful? Please put your hands together for Suzanne and Paul, ladies and gentlemen. Please give it up for my guests, Akmal. And my Pam's people dancers, thank you for choosing to fly Pam Am Airlines, the world's most experienced airline. The fact is we don't make the same mistake more than...
Three times.
Four.
Maybe four.
Seven, actually. Sorry about that. And if you don't tune in next week, I'll find out where you live and I'll fly my bloody plane into your bloody house.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your Captain Rimming speaking. Welcome to Afghanistan. Oh, shit.
For those in economy looking out into Afghanistan thinking, fuck, how am I going to survive that? You're not. I'd like to leave you now with a little number, something I wrote in 1975 when I was Arabic and flew a solid gold plane.